solar-powered home lighting system installation. SELCO office in Hubli receives an inquiry from an end user for a solar home lighting system. The sales executive visits the end user to discuss about the solar home lighting system. He inquires about the number and type of load requirement and the usage hours. He does the site survey along with the end user to find a shadow-free location for placing the panel and also a dry and ventilated place to keep the batteries and checks the wiring layout. He fills the order acknowledgement form and takes the signature of the end user confirming the order and thanks him and leaves. Sales executive arrives at the branch office and briefs the branch manager about the requirement of the end user and submits the order acknowledgement form. Branch manager gives the acknowledgement to the office administrator and briefs him to generate the interbranch memo. The office administrator raises the interbranch memo and goods receipt note and generates a delivery challan which includes the material list and tax and service invoice. He checks the material received from the godown as per the delivery challan. He calls the end user and confirms the availability, date, and time for installation. He gets the signature of branch manager on the delivery challan. Branch manager briefs the technician about the order and asks him to get the material ready. Technician takes the delivery challan, warranty card, installation completion certificate, annual maintenance contract, and user manual with branch seal. He goes to the godown and collects all the components listed in the delivery challan. He packs the safety kit and tools required for installation and loads the components carefully in the pickup truck. He unloads the materials with the help of the assistant and carries it inside the house. Technician reads the end user and takes the signature of the end user on the delivery challan, confirming the delivery of materials. Solar-powered home lighting system components. Panel, 60 watt, 2 numbers. Charge regulator, 12 volt, 10 ampere. LED light, 5 watt, 1 number. LED light, 15 watt, 1 number. Battery, 15 ampere hour. The technician prepares for installation. He wears the safety shoes, jacket, gloves, helmet, and glasses. Enter the serial number of the panel and battery for warranty. Fix the module mounting structure to the panel using nuts, bolts, and screws with the help of spanners. After fixing the panel to the module mounting structure, start wiring of the solar panel. Strip the wires using a wire stripper and connect the lugs using a wire crimper. And then connect it to the PV junction box. Red wire positive, black wire negative. Use of cable lugs allows an easy installation, repair, and maintenance of electrical devices or cables. With the help of drilling machine, make a hole on the sheet for inserting the GI pipe in order to fix the panel. Verify the size of the drilled hole by placing the GI rod. Once the size is verified, fix the GI rod to the wall using clamps, nails, and hammer. Pass the positive and negative wire of the panel through the GI pipe. Fix the panel to the GI pipe. Check the direction using a compass and adjust the panel facing towards south direction with appropriate inclination as per the region of maximum radiation. Fix the module mounting structure by applying the cement and sand mixture at its base. Now, to connect the battery, strip the insulator of the wire using a wire stripper and connect the lugs using wire crimper. Scratch off the metal part of the terminal for better connectivity. Apply petroleum jelly on the terminal to avoid rusting. After that, connect the wires to the terminal using a spanner. Red wire to positive and black wire to the negative terminal. Wind the wire on the rod for flexibility. Now, to connect the charge regulator, keep the charge regulator on the wooden box and mark the place to drill holes for wires. Use a drilling machine and drill 6 holes to connect the positive and negative wires from the solar panel, battery, and load. Fix the charge regulator on the wooden box. Cut the wooden box on the side so that the wire and PVC pipe can be passed through. Pass the wires from the panel, battery, and load through the drilled holes of the wooden box. Mount the wooden box on the wall and fix the charge regulator. Now, do the load luminary wiring by taking the 2 wires from charge regulator through a PVC pipe, which is fixed to the wooden rods of the rooftop using zip tacks. Strip the wires taken from the charge regulator. Connect it to the wires of the luminary, red to red and black to black. Cover the strip part of the wire connection using an insulation tape, black insulation tape to cover black wire connection and red insulation tape to cover the red wire connection. Strip the wire using a wire stripper and attach the lugs using a wire crimper. First, connect the battery wire to the charge regulator. Then, connect the load wire to the charge regulator. And then finally, connect the panel wire to the charge regulator. Strip 3 wires, among which 2 of the load wires are passed through the PVC pipe. Two load wires to be stripped less. A common wire is passed from the charge regulator, and one common wire is to be stripped more and connected to the switch box. He loosens the screws in the switch box and connects the wires. Fix the switch box to the wall using a drilling machine and screwdriver. Switch it on and off in order to check the working of the system. The technician explains the working of the system, the indicators on the charge regulator, and the do's and don'ts, its maintenance and safety measures to be taken while using the system. The end user switches on the luminaries to verify the completion of the installation. Technician takes the signature of end user on the installation completion statement and warranty card and hands over the warranty card and leaves. Thank you.